What a way to start the morning. Chocolate cereal and brain research. Today, we will be talking about brains, or more specifically, why your brain likes music. Music doesn't seem to have any evolutionary advantage. You can't eat it, you can't use it for shelter, you can't mate with it. So essentially, from an evolutionary perspective, what's the point? As it turns out, we as humans have evolved to like music because it makes our brains happy. Studies have shown that when people are listening to pieces of music that they describe as particularly emotional, it activates the subcortical nuclei, or just essentially centers, in your brain that are associated with reward and emotion. Our brain loves to find patterns, and music is particularly conducive to this pattern-finding behavior. As we grow and become more steeped in the music of our culture and society, your brain starts to understand and predict what notes are going to come next, what notes it thinks should come next. To resolve a chord, there are set progressions of major and minor chords that your brain starts to expect, things like that. When a composer or musician surprises your brain and gives you something that your brain wasn't expecting, your brain releases an extra large dose of dopamine. Dopamine is a chemical in your brain that provides messages between different areas of your brain. It's also the molecule released during sex or a particularly delicious meal. The studies that have discovered this have shown that the dopamine is released in anticipation of that moment. So it's like your brain is on a roller coaster. It's going up, up, up to this chord progression that it's expecting, and right before it gets there, it releases a ton of dopamine, and then when it's surprised by that swoop downward or that unexpected sound, fireworks. And this has been since Paleolithic times. Music has been really important to us as a species since our inception, probably because it makes our brains feel good. Studies have also shown that people don't take as much enjoyment in music that isn't from their culture, probably because they can't predict what sound is gonna come next. If you haven't been growing up listening to the patterns in that kind of music, you have no idea what to expect, and any sort of anticipation is just kind of confusion. Now, the centers of your brain that respond pleasurably to music are connected to something called your auditory cortex. That's the part of your brain that takes sounds directly from your ears and processes them as language or music in your brain. Your auditory cortex is what allows you to imagine how a piece of music would sound if it were slightly different, or to compose an entirely new piece of music. Your auditory cortices are really fascinating, and there's a link down below that tells you all about them and is really cool to check out. This question is courtesy of my lovely friend and roommate Marisha, who's studying abroad in the UK right now. I miss you. Thank you for the question. That's all for today. I hope you enjoyed it. Music and the brain is a fascinating topic, and so many people have written about it. Don't forget to check out our Facebook, our Tumblr, and our Twitter down below. Obviously, follow us on YouTube if you'd like. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you guys are having a great day. Don't forget to pack your lunchbox. 'Cause I'm happy. Clap along and give you-